basically sine x, right?
Yes.
So the square is a sine square x. Then this d is a cosine t. Right?
Enough. So why you say this is sine square x? Oops. Why is it x?
Sine square t. Okay. So these two both are the square without the coefficient, so it's a 1.
Yes.
Okay. So this, how are we going to find dy over dx? Okay, this is for a
circle.
Just now the other example was for a circle. Now is a ellipse.
Yes.
Or
oval.
Okay.
We also can say oval, but mostly just children that say oval. Ellipse is more better to say.
Okay.
Ellipse.
So this is how we'll find.
Yes, the minor axis, the area of the ellipse.
So over here, there will be a dy over dx here, right? But is it at the side?
Yes.
Like this?
Yes.
Then this is?
Zero.
Yes.
Zero big A.
Okay, so this will move here. Then yes. Times. From here, times, so divide. So just a reciprocal.
Yes.
So this is what happens. So this dy over dx, your move does a negative. So as this is the reciprocal, there will be a cancelled.
Yes.
X. X will times the b squared. So it's a b squared x over, down here, is a a squared times the y. Okay, so it's just like this. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So now do you know about the coefficient?
Okay.
The coefficient. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So actually we can solve very, very complicated things with this. Correct?
Yes, and we can solve all the questions, we can use the parameter, but...
Okay, so this answer, the final answer can be in
parameter, but it depends on the question. Sometimes the parameter we use it very easy, but sometimes we use it very hard. It depends on
sometimes the question. It's just an x and y. Sometimes there might also be y prime. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. So it depends on the question, as you said, correct?
Yes.
Okay, but if it is this question written above, what do you think it will be? Okay, first we need to let it go.
Enough, so.
You see, so this looks quite complicated, right?
Yes.
Ba.
You know, ba is yes. And I will say ba, you know, ba like this.
Okay, so this is actually the cubic root theta plus e to the power of sine theta plus ln modulus theta. Well, let it be t
equals.
Okay, so you want to use equals, the equal sign?
No, b, let.
Okay, if you want equals, you need to be like this. Okay, so this becomes the sine t cosine t, right?
Yes.
So sine t cosine t, dy over dx, this becomes a negative x over y, isn't it?
Yes.
But if the
Yes.
So this negative tangent t. T, isn't it actually this?
Yes, I've got
so. Okay. Just write this.
I think I'll think that. But you will use the label.
Isn't it just like this?
Yes.
So you can see, it makes things easier sometimes, but it can make things harder.
Yes.
Right?
Sometimes harder, sometimes easier.
It depends on the question. Okay?
Yes.
And remember the chain rule.
Yes.
The chain rule is the trick.
Trick to solve all of these questions.
Yes. The chain rule is very, very important.
If we don't know, it's
case closed.
Okay? Nothing you can solve closed.
Okay. So here's the 1, 2, 3, 4. It's just like this, a normal T, it can be a square cube, it can be a square root. Also, there can be the coefficient.
D squared y over dx squared.
Okay, so this is a negative 1 over y cube.
Wait, I found a pattern here.
Okay, can you look at the denominator and find a pattern?
Yes, 1 to the power of 1 to the power of 3 to the power of 5 to the power of
3. Okay, no, not that. Okay, so when there are just two times on the differentiation, it is a negative 1 over y cubed.
Write it down.
As for example, all these questions we solved before.
Write it down.
Wait. Now is to find if this question it is
solved
two times of differentiation. Okay? Yes.
Don't erase that. That. I think don't erase that.
Okay. So this negative 1 over y cubed. You know that it's actually a negative secant cubed. T, right?
Yes.
So we can write this as negative secant cube this. So it might seem quite long, but it actually very simple, right?
Oh.
So this third, now do you know what is it like? Third, how can we write it as? Usually write this as, isn't it like negative 3 times the 3 sine t over cosine to the power of 5 t, right?
Yes.
So we can just write it like this.
What does?
So this t, we'll just put it here. So is it like this?
Like?
It might seem complicated, but it's actually simple, right?
Yes.
It's just as simple as this.
As simple as 1, 2, 3? No.
Okay. As simple as 1, 2, 3 is just how you say things that are very easy, okay?
Yes.
Okay, you also can say that it's just at your fingertips.
Yes.
Okay?
Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Okay, so I got this 3 times.
Yes.
Okay, so the 4 times is next. Okay, so for the 4 times, here's a negative. So his 3 don't change, as you said, 1 don't change. X is actually a sine, right?
Yes.
So it's a 4 sine square.
Correct.
Cosine to the power of 7, then just
up the phone.